Hello, and welcome to another episode. So let's talk about a jewel of the night sky, the M5 Globular Cluster, and how to find it. A globular cluster is an ancient cluster, the oldest part of the Milky Way, formed when the galaxy itself was still forming, lying inside the galactic halo which extends around the Milky Way. Unlike open clusters which disperse over time, globular clusters stay tightly packed for billions of years. The M5 cluster is 13 billion years old, making it one of the oldest globular clusters. How globular clusters form is poorly understood, but they are believed to evolve like this, slowly coming together over time. It is thought that globular clusters originate from areas where there is a lot of star formation, and the interstellar medium has a high density, but after the cluster is formed, there seems to be no further star formation. Globular clusters are beautiful objects in the night sky, showing so many stars packed together, and the M5 cluster is no exception. In fact, this cluster has always been a favourite for observers since it was discovered and referred to by Admiral Smythe as a superb object, a noble mass, refreshing to the senses after searching for faint objects. But you will need to use high powers to have the same result yourself. So, what do you need to see M5? Shining at magnitude 5.7, M5 is one of the brightest globular clusters in the night sky, and is actually visible to the naked eye under dark skies as a faint point of light. With binoculars, it is easily visible as a small fuzzy patch. A small 80mm or 3.1-inch telescope reveals a nebulous ball with a bright core. A 100mm or 4-inch telescope under excellent dark skies will start to resolve individual stars in the cluster, the brightest of which are 11th magnitude. The image should indicate what you will see through a 150mm or 6-inch telescope. As you can see, at highest power, stars are resolvable outside of the boundaries of M5. While this long exposure image wouldn't be visible for a large telescope, it gives an indication of what you could see with a larger telescope, with many more stars coming into view, radiating like chains or legs outwards from the bright compact center. So, how to find M5? The best time of year to see M5 is during the months of March, April, and May. To find M5, first go to the Bootis constellation, which is supposed to resemble a herdsman. This constellation also contains the fourth brightest star in the sky, Arcturus. From Arcturus, head down to Zeta Bootis, in the herdsman's right leg, and from there hop down to the 109 Herculis in the constellation Hercules, then across to 110 Herculis, and keep on heading in the same direction using a low power eyepiece to scan the area for the globular cluster. Well, that's all for another episode. Please leave a like if you like this episode, it really helps out the channel. If you have any questions, please leave a comment below, and if you'd like to see more astronomy episodes, then please do subscribe. Goodbye and clear skies.